Hello, beautiful one. So happy to be with you today. This is Sylvia Mordini, the founder of Life Inspired and Alchemy of Yoga. And probably what you notice right away is that one, I'm wearing my glasses, which I don't often do. And I'm in this beautiful new studio. Where am I? Well, I'm excited to announce that I am going to be teaching at the Body Electric in St. Petersburg, Florida. So I'm here at the B right now, and I thought I'd just do a little bit of a sweet soulful flow, and that way you could get an idea of what to expect. And for those of you that are joining me from all over the world, happy, happy day to you all, and let's flow, shall we? So come into a comfortable seat, sit tall, bottoms of the hands on our knees, and just press down a little bit, and then a gentle resistance up. It's not a fight. It's just an engagement. And then soften what doesn't need to be hard or difficult in that engagement of pressing down and lifting up at the same time. See if you can close your eyes to tune in to the engagement of the presence of the up energy. This is known as pranavayu, the five wind energies. And the hands pressing down is a downward energy of pranavayu. So we know these energies exist in the form of fire that rises up and the form of rain that flows down from the sky. And we need the alchemical experience of all the elements. Downward energy of the earth, the water, the upward energy of the fire, air, and ether. And they're all around us and they're inside us. So now press your knees down on your own, but inhale, turn your palms open and lift them upwards towards the sky. And that's the name of this studio. Exhale, palms down. Move your hands downward, pranavayu. Inhale, palms open, upwards, pranavayu, the rising energy. And then palms down, exhale, the downward energy, pranavayu. Keep going, and you could open your eyes or just tune into the movement. As you breathe in and your hands move up, your diaphragm moves down. And now, as you breathe out and your palms move down, your diaphragm moves up. Inhaling, the physical body on the outside is moving up, but notice how your sit bones and your low belly get stronger, heavier, pelvic floor. And now, when your palms and the physical body move down, feel how there's this lift of your belly in and up. So the diaphragm has this upliftment. One more. And so whenever you breathe in, your diaphragm moves down. And whenever you breathe out, your diaphragm moves up. So we're constantly in this engagement. And just rest your hands for a moment. Pause to feel. And so the up and the down energy, the sun, the moon, the day, the night, they're just constantly there. We'll bring our feet over to the right side. Aim your knees forward to the long side of your mat. And just both hands to the left. Honoring this direction, the energy of the feminine, of the moon. And so we would say that these are the energies of like earth and water, like Mama Earth, Panchamama, Mama Gaia, she who's known by so many names. Inhale, look forward. Exhale, release to frame your body with your fingertips. Walk your right hand out. Inhale, left arm up. Exhale, lean over to the right. So feel the downward energy of your left hip. It's moving down. And then there's this up energy of your left arm to the upper diagonal to the sky. Inhale, both arms reach out. Exhale, hands unite to the midline. from Barabhadrasana, lean left and bring your right foot on the outside of your knee. Hold your shin and sit tall. Now, if this is really uncomfortable and you're overly leaning to the left hip, then we just do this. We bring our foot inside our knee, and then we can get grounded. We need the grounding and the stable energy of the apana vayu. So never sacrifice the grounding energy for the sake of the shape of the pose. Inhale, right hand comes behind us. And as you exhale, just hug your right knee in, rotating your left ribs towards your thigh. So it doesn't have to be this elbow out and harsh or hard. It can just be engaged from the center, hugging in. Push down in your right foot and lift up through the crown of your head, twisting, twisting. Ardhanasanasana. Inhale, look forward. And then exhale, release. Bring both your feet over to the left, a sloppy pile of knees to the long side of the mat, and now we're on our right hip. From here, both hands to the right, inhale, puff up your chest, open up and feel that energy up, and then exhale, keep the up energy to the twist. Twists are generally energized. They are those things that are pranavayu, upliftment, energy, vitality, detoxification. Inhale, look forward. Exhale, release. Nice. Now, frame your body with your fingertips and try to even things out. Rise up through the crown, pranavayu. Root down, apanavayu. And we'll walk our left fingertips out. Inhale, right arm up and over. Now use that play of contrary complements. Right hip is pressing down, left hand is pressing down, and then right arm is reaching up to the diagonal. Look where it feels good. Inhale, both arms reach up. Exhale, hands unite, bring them down midline. And then lean right and help your left foot come outside your knee. Hold your shin. Now, if this, again, is creating a position that's ungrounded, it's not worth the sacrifice. So you could bring your foot inside your knee, test it out, or outside. Now, squeeze into the midline, and that will help you feel lifted up and rooted down. If there's a lack of squeezing, then we just kind of collapse, holding down, but not up. Left hand behind us, take a breath in. Grow taller, taller, taller. Create some space between your vertebrae so you're safe. And then take your time twisting to the left. Squeeze in and root down in your left foot, pushing it down and forward. And see if that helps you twist a little bit more. I hope so. Inhale, bring your gaze back to center. Exhale, release back to the center. And then undo your left foot. Nice. Walk your hands to the short side of the mat to your right. It's the easy side, away from your feet. Take a breath. Exhale, bend your elbows a little bit. Chaturanga Dandasana. Bind your hands so that they're circling the ground. And then lower again, Chaturanga. Three, four more. So there's these bandhas, blocks of energy. And when we're spreading our hand bones, hands are pressing the ground. Hasta means standard arm. Hasta bandha. Just like binding poses in other positions with the hands behind our back. One more little chaturanga. And then press up. Now, find your toes, lift your bottom hip, and you're in a little twisty dog. And then pivot, turn your toes the only other direction, and then pivot. And go back and forth, steer dog. Lots of different names I've found. But next time your knees are pointing to the right side of your mat, stay there. Bring your left hip down. Take a breath, even the weight in your hands, more on your right. Exhale to your under. Inhale up. Exhale down. Now if your hands are way too far forward, then your elbows won't be by your ribs. So make sure, as you bend, that your
elbows are kind of tucked back, and your hands are close enough. Try to reach your thumbs towards one another and spread your hand bones. Last time up, take a big breath in. Exhale. Find your toes, lift your left hip, and then ski it out. Or just twist your downward dog. Twisting, twisting. Press down in your hands, and you'll find a rebound of energy as we come into downward facing dog in its traditional form of the sit bones up. So sit bones in the back of our legs are lifting up, pranavayama. Push down your hands and feet to stay stable and grounded. And so that's apanavayama. Inhale, lift your heels. Feel everything up, up, up. Keep the up, but then press your heels down. So we're doing both at the same time. Once more, inhale, lift your heels. Exhale down. Inhale, shift forward, plank. Bend your knees, knees to the left. Come into your left fingertips, or if you want, left hand up. It's a little variation of Vashastasana. Inhale, stretch to the short side of the mat, look down. Exhale, hips high. Press into the webbing of your fingers and forward. Yeah, push down to lengthen and left. Inhale, lift your heels, pull your belly in, dome forward, plank. Exhale, bend your knees, turn to the right, and come into your right fingertips or right arm. Inhale, right arm stretches to the short side. Exhale, right hand down, hips high, downward facing dog. Start to walk your hands backwards. Down, 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 but feel the tilt of your pelvis so that you can get your sit bones up without overdoing it. If you have a tendency to be overly flexible, then you know who you are. And then everybody, squeeze your lower legs together, shins in, and that's going to help your feet, that part that's locked, bound with the ground, it's going to help them feel heavy and pushing down upon a regular. Squeeze lower legs together, press upper thighs apart. And then soften your knees. Hands climb to our thighs. Inhale, lift your chest. And lift your sit bones. Crown your head high. This is a puppy tilt, cow tilt. Exhale, round, cat tilt. Inhale, the anterior tilt. Lift the top of your head. Exhale, round. Lift the back of your heart. Inhale. Notice what's heavy and pushing down. Exhale. Notice what's light and lifting up. And then notice the reverse. On this last time, as you round, come all the way up, shoulders back. Inhale, arms forward and up. Lift your heels just a little bit, just enough to put a piece of paper underneath. And as you press into the ball bounce of your feet, that should give you stability. There's going to be micro movements for sure. That's okay. It's the body constantly trying to find its balance and equilibrium. But push down and then see if you can get a little taller. Inhale. Exhale. Hands come through heart center and fold forward. Inhale. Walk your hands all the way back out to plank. Take a breath. Exhale, knees bent, point them to the left. Inhale, left arm up. Exhale, left hand down, downward facing dog. Inhale, shift to plank. Exhale, bend your knees back, point them to the right. Inhale, right arm up. Exhale, right hand down, downward facing dog. Inhale, right foot steps forward. Exhale, left knee lower. Inhale, arms forward and up. Now exhale, palms turn down and move to touch the ground. Palms turn up. Inhale, lift up. Palms turn down and bow forward, touch the earth. Inhale, palms up. Lift up. Sky. Exhale, all the way to earth. 11 o'clock. Inhale, lift and lengthen. Stay here, the pyramid that's high. Or exhale, fold. Hands are framing your foot. And so push down to lift your sit bones, still an anterior tilt here. If you want more pushing down, one fun thing is to push your hands forward, press back, kind of like a down dog. Inhale, lift your back heel, put a little bend in your front knee. Exhale as your right foot roots down, left leg lifts, breathing in. Supported warrior three. So press down and then engage the back of your left leg. Engage your glute, your seat. Inhale. Exhale, soft landing, the back of the mat. And then step back, top of a push-up. Breathe in. Exhale, bend your knees, point them to the left. Inhale, this little vinyasa. Exhale, plank. Inhale, knees to the right, right arm up. Exhale, plank to downward dog. Inhale, left foot steps forward to the front, back and down. Inhale, arms forward and up. Now pause down, exhale. Feel the downward energy. Now squeeze your legs in and inhale. As you squeeze in, palms are lifting up. Your lower legs are very stable. Now as you exhale, stop the squeezing and let them settle. Inhale, squeeze. Feel every bit of energy in your body lift up. Exhale. Surrender and allow the energy of the prana body to happen. Inhale. Feel the exuberance press into your left foot. Exhale. We lower down. Pick your back knee up. And then step it a little bit closer, toes to 2 o'clock or 1 o'clock. Inhale, lift up. Stay here to the pyramid. Or go lower in your pyramid. Think of the back of your leg lifting up and the front of your body like water cascading, moving down. Another variation besides hands forward is hands back. Walk your hands out, back heel lifts. Put a little bend in your left knee and then use your seat muscles to push down your left foot. Inhale, lift your right leg up, no higher than your hip. And give your legs a little squeeze to the midline. Coming into your fingertips or bricks underneath our hands and then continue to breathe. The more you press down, the lighter the lift of the right leg. This is supported warrior three. Inhale. Exhale, as slow as you can, slower than you want to. Let your right toes discover the ground. So it's not that dropping because of the abdominal. Inhale, plank. Exhale, knees to the left. Inhale, left arm up. Exhale, plank. Inhale, bend your knees. Aim them to the right. Vinyasa. Exhale, through the plank. Downward facing dog. Take a big breath in. Exhale, right knee lowers. Inhale, left leg lifts. Use your seat. And it should feel like what we did when we were standing on our right foot. Same shape. Right arm forward if you wish. Now, if we collapse in our wrists, it will just feel heavy. So, unshrug the wrist, feel the up energy as much as the stability of the down energy. Inhale, exhale, right hand down, left foot flat like a warrior two. Inhale, left arm up. Exhale, reach it over your head to the diagonal. Take a breath, push anything down that's on the ground as your foundation. Exhale, look down. Now calmly play with the engagement of the downward energy. So it's not a collapse, it's the down energy. Inhale, downward facing dog. Stay for the exhale. Inhale, shift forward and soft landing with your left knee underneath your hand. breath. So control the down energy. Inhale, use your seat to lift your right leg. Now we press the ground away, a little bit of a posterior tilt in the hips, and protract your shoulders. Inhale, left arm forward. Find that balance of up energy in your right breast and down energy in your left shin and the top of your left foot. Inhale, exhale, control left hand to come down, right toes down, flatten the outside edge of the right foot. Inhale, right arm up. Exhale, it reaches to the diagonal. And so notice your left waistline lifting to your right waistline. So there's that up energy. But then at the same time, we're pressing into our left shin, pressing down, panavayam to the bottom of the right foot. Inhale, open your throat. Now look down. Exhale. Stay engaged with the down energy as the right hand comes down slow without collapsing the wrist. And then inhale, downward facing dog, Adho Mukha Svanasana. Stay for the exhale. Inhale, walk forward to the center of your mat. Exhale, bend your knees, come down from all palms. Take a breath, curl your chin in, breathe out. Honoring the earth, face towards the earth. Thank you, thank you, thank you, earth. In our engaged relationship with the earth, knees could open, could come down lower. Your head could come all the way down if you want. And then squeeze your knees back together if they open. Hug in. And then, like a candle, light up the crown of your head, palms to our hearts. Light up your fingers and feel the up energy, pranavayam. If you're just collapsing in your seat on your heels, you can start to feel heavy in your ankles. So feel as if you're lifting up an eighth of an inch, just a tiny little bit. So it looks like we're just sitting low, but we're actually squeezing in and lifting up. And then slow as you can, come to have a seat. Bottoms of our feet come together and fold forward. You could hold your feet, your hands could walk out. If you want variations, you could create yoga mudra, reaching your knuckles to the sky while your head is to the earth. All just options. Inhale, come up. Exhale, let your legs get long. And then from here, inhale, both arms lift up. Exhale, take that up energy and move it forward to the diagonal. Inhale a little bit more. Press the tops of your thighs to the bottoms of your thighs. Exhale, fold. Inhale, lengthen a little bit. Exhale, fold. Inhale, forward. Exhale, release. Bend your legs, scoop forward a little bit. Just come on down, nice and slow. Hands to your belly button and below. You could make a little diamond shape or a triangle. Take a breath. Exhale, knees over to the left a little bit, arms just over your head, more to the right. Taking out the heart angles. Inhale, center. And exhale, our knees just as far as they go, a little to the right, and arms are just relaxing to the left. Inhale, center. Exhale, arms come all the way down. Hug your back body together, but try not to push the chest overly up. Instead, lower the low belly down, low back on the ground, engage your legs to the midline,
doesn't have to be high. So pressing into your feet, feel as if they're both pulling towards you and away. Inhale. And that will then help buoy the front body up. Exhale. Rolling down nice and easy. Take a big breath in. Open mouth, exhale. Draw your knees in, holding the backs of your legs without pulling the sacrum off the ground. And legs might straighten a little bit or a lot. They could be straight up and down or more of that bit of a diagonal. Just give the weight of your back to the ground. So we're inverting, our head is lower than our heart, and most of the day our feet are always receiving the apana vayu, the downward energy. And now our legs are above us, and our upper body and our head is receiving the downward energy. So think of downward energy, apana vayu, calm. If your mind feels anxious, overwhelmed, distracted, we invert. And you could do the same pose with your legs against a wall in your house or a studio. And then bend in. If your hands easily go to your shins, let them be there. Otherwise, to the back of your legs or even just next to you. And then feel the weight of your shins, the apana vayu, give their weight to the back of your calves. Give the weight of your calves to the backs of your thighs. Give the weight of the backs of your thighs to the fronts of your thighs. Give the weight of the fronts of your thighs to your belly. Give the weight downwards of the front of your belly to your back. Just feel the apana vayu. Ready, feet to the earth, or you can do legs up the wall pose, or extend your legs into final relaxation, but let everything feel heavy, as if you had this energy blanket that had some weight, and they sell weighted blankets now. And just allow yourself to rest. You stay there resting on your back, or if you're joining from home and you know you'd like a blanket, put that on top of you. And allow yourself to feel as if the sky is just getting closer to you. Like how during the day, beautiful blue sky day, and the sky feels so far away, but then at night, the canopy of the darkness feels like it's closer and the world is smaller. So feel the comfort in that apana vayu, the downward energy. This Mama Earth, Panchamama, supports you, the back of your body with a warm embrace. And you feel Father Sky in front of you embrace you on that side as well, so that you, as this beautiful child of the universe, feels the ultimate comfort between sky and earth. Just like here in the two studios at the Body Electric Yoga Studio in St. Petersburg, Florida, the B. As you want. Take what you need from the downward energy.
my heart to your heart, to the heart of the universe. May you love yourself, love your day, and love your life.